Parkinson's disease is a neurologic disorder that's primarily manifest as motor difficulties, tremor, rigidity, some trouble with walking and balance. It can also affect other parts of the body, such as the gastrointestinal tract, leading to constipation and other kinds of symptoms. The NINDS, the National Institute of Neurologic Disorders and Stroke, is invested in finding better treatments for people with Parkinson's disease. Towards this goal, one of our activities is to work towards finding biomarkers in Parkinson's disease. A biomarker is a marker that is either a clinical, that is a physical exam finding, or a biologic that is through biospecimens such as blood or other body fluid marker to help us gauge the presence of the disease and the state of the disease. The reason this is important is that Parkinson's disease is not always evident prior to symptom onset in the clinic. Sometimes the disease will begin even decades before we can see it in the clinic, but without biomarkers, we can't actually gauge its progression pre-symptomatically. The other issue is that it's very important for us to do clinical trials where we can better discover drugs that will treat Parkinson's disease, but that is very hard to do without a biomarker that will tell us whether or not the medication we're testing actually impacts the real cause of the disease. Both patients and controls are being enrolled now in the Parkinson's Disease Biomarkers Program. Our goal is to enroll approximately 1,500 people across the United States, and I'm happy to report that we've enrolled about 1,000 people. One of those people is Dr. Zimmet, who was the first patient to be enrolled at Johns Hopkins University. He will share his experiences as a patient in the Parkinson's Disease Biomarkers Program and what it's been like to be a participant. We'd like to thank him and all the other participants in the Parkinson's Disease Biomarkers Program for the important goal of finding better treatments for Parkinson's disease.
I'm a dentist, and I've been a dentist for 40 years. And at the end of 2006, I noticed in my practice I was going to give an injection or do some work that I saw a slight tremor in my right hand. And that was bothersome. But I remember about 20 years before that, I had the same issue, and I went to the doctor then, and it turned out that my thyroid was out of whack. So he fixed my thyroid, taking some medicines. I thought that would do it. Lo and behold, did I know that it turned into be Parkinson's. And when I was sure that besides affecting my professional life, it dramatically affected my family life, because I have 3 children, a couple of grandchildren, and obviously a wife, and I knew that they would be involved in everything that happened with our lives changing, not just financially, but emotionally. In the 7 years that I've had Parkinson's, my disease has progressed. When they say Parkinson is a chronic progressive disease, it absolutely is. I went from minimal or no symptoms to now symptoms and on and off times of the disease. The studies themselves are very interesting. You sit down with a neurologist, and in most cases, you get alone one-on-one time with them during the study, ask any question you want. That's worth its weight in gold, to have that one-on-one time with a neurologist, even if it's not your neurologist, just to pick their brains and say, here's what I'm doing. Do you have any ideas that you might suggest that would make life better for me? So when, after I got through the informed consent for the biomarker study at the Hopkins, the first thing they did, if I remember correctly, is they drew some blood, which is just a routine blood like you do in any doctor's office. It's very simple. And then we did some cognitive tests, very simple looking things, saying back things, basically memory testing in a way, so they can track your cognitive ability over the course of the disease. And then came the spinal tap thing. And never had the spinal tap before. Even though I have a scientific background, I was a little skittish about that. But after talking to Dr. Rosenthal, you know, there's virtually no chance of getting paralyzed. There's no chance of really much of anything, but maybe getting a headache if in some cases, which that has not happened to me. And the care partner can also be involved in the research end of it. When I go for a trial, she's a healthy subject. She is a healthy subject to do a trial. The biomarkers people want healthy subjects, so they have some basis to compare things on. So whoever your care partner is can take the journey with you just from a different level. But I think, you know, go to trial finders at Fox or clinicaltrials.gov and find what trials that are there and that might interest you and go from there. Just remember, be proactive and be, you know, in not just your care, but in helping the future of Parkinson's and in helping stop, cure, prevent, whatever, this wonderful disease that we're stuck with.